Hi, this is David from Minute Earth. If you look up the life expectancy of a human, you'll find that it's about 72 years. For a dog, you'll find that it's about 14 years. And for a loggerhead sea turtle, you'll see that it's about 80 years. But these numbers can actually be compared because they were calculated using three different definitions of the term life expectancy. The one we use for humans is life expectancy at birth. Basically, we say if a group of individuals are all born in the same year and die whenever they die, what would their average age of death be? But if we use that formula for dogs and loggerheads, we'd get 10 and 3.5, which is pretty different from what you'd find if you looked it up, because for dogs, we use life expectancy after babyhood. Instead of averaging out the age when every individual dies, we ignore the animals that die early in life, and instead average out the age when all the non-infants die. Likely because pet owners mostly care about how long their dog's lives are expected to be, given that they've already survived infancy. But if we use this formula with humans and sea turtles, we'd get 75 and 7, which is somewhat similar for humans, but not for turtles, because for them, life expectancy usually means maximum life expectancy, how long the oldest individuals live. That's probably because when we talk about less familiar species, we're mostly curious about how long they can live. But if we did that for humans and dogs, we'd get 122 and 29. These conflicting definitions of life expectancy make it really hard to understand how these animals live and die. Instead of focusing on a singular number, we can actually learn much more about animals by graphing all the different ages when they die, which we can then convert into an equivalent graph showing what percentage of individuals are expected to survive to any given age. Each green bar represents the individuals from the group that are still alive after a certain age, and the way the bars drop can teach us a bunch about the animals they represent. For example, this drop-off between the first and second bars represents the infant mortality rate. Some animals, like humans, have just a little drop-off, which means the parents do a lot of intensive care and not too many babies die. Some animals, like dogs, have a slightly larger drop-off, which usually indicates that parents have slightly larger litters and occasionally lose pups. Other animals, like sea turtles, have huge drop-offs, which usually means that parents don't do a lot of care and a lot of babies die. The bars in the early middle part of the distribution represent early adulthood. For humans and dogs, the bars here stay pretty much the same height, as they are less likely to die when they are both big enough to defend themselves and not yet slowed by age. But for sea turtles, the trend continues to curve downward, which suggests that for them, this part of life is still riddled with dangers. The end of the distribution is kind of hard to see, so let's zoom in on a few. Humans and dogs tend to fall off a cliff near the end. It suggests that our health gives out quickly once we get old. But the distribution curve of some other animals, like sea turtles, instead gets flatter, suggesting that the few individuals that make it to super seniorhood not only don't get sick, but they're actually better protected from death than when they were younger. These final few data points are where you can find the oldest humans, oldest dogs, and oldest sea turtles, the maximum life expectancy crowd. But to better understand the life and death of all of the animals, it's best not to just focus on the maximum life expectancy, or just on the life expectancy at birth, or life expectancy after babyhood, but instead to look at the big picture and take a curve's eye view.
I put together something to give everyone a bit more of a hands-on understanding of these different kinds of life expectancies and survival curves. The lab also has a bunch of animals that we didn't have time for in the video, like cats, whales, robins, and so on and so on. To see it, just click the link down below, or you can go to minutelabs.io and find the Survival Curves lab along with a ton of other fun interactives.